The first time that Bert Hölldobler and I went into the field and did serious field work together, before that time we'd mostly worked in the lab, was 1985, and we went down to the field station of the Organization for Tropical Studies at La Selva in Costa Rica. And for every field station, there is what I like to call a golden interval. And that is, it comes after the station is established. And after enough facilities have been built to make it comfortable, so you're not sleeping in a hammock and beating off mosquitoes and eating mush for you know, your meal. It becomes reasonably comfortable facilities, but not so far along that it's lost its virginal character, you know, for whatever group. The butterflies haven't been well studied yet. The frogs are only partly known. The botany is being explored by colleagues. People are beginning to come in. And we hit it at a time when almost nothing had been done on the ants. So we had about a week together. And it was splendid because this has an extremely rich fauna there. There are over 50 species in one genus that I specialize on, the genus Pheidole, 50. That's more species by a factor of about 10 than you have in all the eastern United States in that one locality. And then genus after genus, you know, all kinds of wonderful ants, most of which had never been studied. So he and I were like a couple of kids, you know, turned loose in the woods for the first time, scrambling along the trail and shouting back and forth to one another. And I could say, "Bert, here's a colony of Prionopelta." And he would say, "Quick, come here, I think I've got a Eurhopalothrix," and so on. And all of these things then we would look at and we'd take back to the lab. Not a lab exactly, it was sort of just a little workstation in one of the cabins. And we had the instruments to do simple experiments on division of labor, on pheromones, on basic behavior, on what they ate, and so on. And when we came back with our data and our specimens and so on, we quickly proceeded to publish 5 refereed papers, and they were good papers too. They were very original, and in almost each case, the first observations of a real scientific nature on an entire group of ants that had, you know, that had never before been studied. So that's a kind of rich experience that one can have if you take a group that hasn't been exhaustively studied, and that's almost every group in the world, with the possible exception maybe of birds. You know where to go, and you hit do the fieldwork just right. It's an exhilarating experience.